Hello everyone, I have noticed quite a few people have troubles with multi-level pointers. But don't worry, after this tutorial you shouldn't have any more problems. I'm going to teach you how to use the pointer scanner. The advantage of the pointer scanner is it can save a lot of time. Not only that, but most pointers are very hard to do manually. It's always better to cheat in the long run. I will use World of Warcraft as an example. Please take note, your game program may vary in the difficulty in this tutorial. World of Warcraft has hundreds of memory addresses, so it should be very difficult compared to other games. Okay, let's get started by booting Cheat Engine. In this tutorial, I'm in a private server, so I can't get banned. It's an all-GM server, which is hosted by Germans. In this video may be laggy to you because I'm not using Fraps to record. Okay, let's say if I wanted to pointer to the chat in World of Warcraft. The first thing I need to do is obviously to find the address of the chat. Okay, now that I have the address, I'm going to right click and then click find out what accesses this address. When I go in game, I will get debugger addresses. The advantage of this is the code in the debugger are usually static and do not change. Usually multiple will show. So you're going to have to find the debugger command that has the least amount of instructions on it. To do this, you have to click Show Dissembler and find out what addresses write accesses. If it shows you a bunch of addresses, try a new debugger command. I would recommend from top to bottom. As you see here, these are not the correct addresses, so we'll go down again. Okay. This one does have the correct address in it. So I'm going to write down this address, 00962CF5. Obviously, it's going to be different for you because it's a different game, different things. This is the address I want to find. Okay. I'm going to write down that address in Notepad, the debugger address that I just found. Keep that in a safe location. Okay. Now right click the address you just added and click pointer scan for this address. Depending on how many processes you have, change the number of thread scanning right here to the amount of your processors. In my case, I have 4 processors, so I'm going to put 4 and then I'm going to click OK. I already have some saved, but I'm gonna redo it anyway. It is very important you keep saved files of the pointer scanner, so please put it in a safe place. Being organized is the key to the pointer scanner. When it is finished, you want to either restart your game. Remember that the debugger address I told you to write down. I hope you do. Attach cheat engine to your game again. your 1-2-click memory view, and you're going to press Control G, and you're going to type that address that you wrote down. And then you're going to find out what access is it. And the address will appear on the list. In which case, that is the correct address. What I'm going to do is copy this address. Right click pointer scan. You're going to click cancel. Open the one that you just saved. Open the PTR file. And then you're going to click rescan memory and type the address that the debugger found and put it and save it. Always keep backups of the pointer scanner. It usually scans quickly. Keep restarting your game until you get an ideal amount of pointers, such as 15, 100, or 1,000. They usually all work. Most of them will fail. This is why you need to keep backups. Ideally, since you scanned most pointers, will work for a short time. You can cheat and copy the address the majority is pointing to. As you see here, they're all pointing to nothing because I just disconnected. Mind my horrible train wreck here, I'm going to see what the majority is pointing to. As you see here, OE. So I must assume that the pointer is OE. Is that so? I'm going to scan for that address. Make sure you type it in correctly. There you go. You have a multi-level pointer. This will work on the tutorial. And I hope you can finally do multi-level pointers. Thanks for watching.